Now we'll see the another concept called views. So views is very, very important topic in SQL, because views are just like a database object, like a table, but there are a lot of differences between table and views. So what is view in SQL? A view is a virtual table based on a result set of an SQL statement. So normally where we need to use these views is, suppose as a user, I have some table, I have created some tables. As a user, I have created some tables, I have some data in my tables. And some other user requested to access my tables. He needs access of some of the tables which are created by me. So if I provide complete access on my tables to other users, so he can do anything. So he can update the data, he can delete the data, he can correct the structure, anything he can do that. So instead of doing that, what I can do is, first of all, I'll ask him what are the different columns you need. And then once you get that information, then I can create some view based on my table, and then I will provide access only on that particular view. So now other guy can use the view for him purpose. So view is basically a logical object, and it is basically a logical object. It doesn't have any physical structure. And based upon the result of the select query, the result of the select query can be stored in the view. So for example, simple example is, and by using this, you can easily understand what is exactly view is. I have a table, right? So I have a three columns in the table, and I have multiple rows in a table. So when I write a select query, so select some two columns, and I have retrieved some data based on certain condition. So this particular query will give you some result. So that particular result, I will store in a view. I will store that result in the view. Result is in a sense, result also records, right? Result is also contains the records, number of rows and columns. So those rows and columns I will store in the view, and I will give access on this particular view to the other users. Instead of providing the access to this table, I will provide the some permissions on this view. Now, that is the main usage of view. So to restrict the access level, instead of giving the exact table to the other users, we can just create a view and we can give the access privileges to the other users. But exactly what is view? How we can define the view? So view is a logical structure of a table. So we can create a view based on one table or multiple tables. Sometimes we can write the select query by using multiple tables, right? So these records is getting from the multiple tables. So views can be created based upon one table or multiple tables. And view is a logical object. It is not a physical object. It will not occupy any memory location. Whereas tables will is a physical object. The data is exactly reside that. But in the view, we don't have any data. Views will have the data, but that is a logical data. So simply you can say, if you understand table and view, if you see your mirror, so there is a mirror. If you stand in front of the mirror, the image will be displayed on the mirror. So whatever you have, same thing exactly will appear in the mirror also. But this guy having physical presence, physical appearance, but this is not having that. This is a logical. So just an image is displaying here, right? Same thing, if I create a view, that is just a mirror image of the table. So mirror image of the table. View doesn't contain any data, but it will show the data whichever is there in the table itself. So here, whatever image is displaying is the not original image, is displaying the image of the actual person. Similarly, the view also presenting some data which is already there in the table. It will not create any specific structure or specific data. It doesn't contain any data specially. Okay, so this is basically concept of view. So why we need to go for views is only for security purpose. So instead of giving the tables access, we can just create some views and give the access to the views on the or to the other users. So a view is a virtual table based on the result set of a SQL statement we have to create. So a view contains rows as well as columns, just like a real table. The fields in a view are fields from one or more real tables in a database. So we can create the views from multiple tables also. And we can also apply all kinds of SQL joins, subqueries, like join subqueries, set operators, everything, whatever we discuss are functions, built-in functions, everything can be worked on the views also. So whatever operations have done in the table, the same kind of operators, SQL statement, everything will work on the views. User perspective, there is no difference. So all the SQL commands will work on the views also. So let me show you how to create a views. So let me just execute these commands. So I have a HR database. Suppose when I say select star from employees, this will create all the data. So I don't want to provide all the columns and all the data to the user. So what I can do is I will just create a view on this particular table. So how to create a view is, the command is create view. So just like a table, create view, view name, give some name, employees underscore V underscore one. So just give one name to the view as is a keyword. And here we need to write a SQL query. So whatever records this SQL query is returned, those records will be there in this particular view. And still this is the logical. So select employee ID, first name, salary. I'm getting only three columns, employee ID, first name and salary from employees. And I'm providing these three columns only to the other user. So based on these columns, I'm creating this particular view. So create a view, view name as select employee ID, first name, salary from employees. I'm giving some information to the other users by using this particular view. Now let me just create the view. So when I execute this statement, this will create a new view here. So now it is created a new view. Where exactly we can see this view is, just go to HR here, employees table, and here refresh this. Under employees table, there is one column called views. Yeah, here it is. Sorry, so tables, these are all tables, and there is one more thing called views here. Under views, you can see employees underscore view one is created. Now, if you select the data from the view, select the star from view name. Now, this will give you only that particular data. Employee ID, first name, salary only we have selected from employees table. So this view contains only this particular data. So views are logical objects we can create, and whatever select command will return the result set. So the view will have that particular data. And if you want to drop the view, just like a table. So drop view, view name. So this will drop the view. So once you deleted this, the view will be dropped. So all the DDL, DML, DCA, all the commands will work on the views as usual. So no difference at all. Okay. But view is a simple logical object, which is created based upon the SQL command. And what is the use of view is, instead of providing the complete access on the table to the user, we have to just create a view and we can provide access on the view. So even the user is do anything on the view, original tables will not be affected. Okay, so that's most important. And one more important point here is, so I say this is the view, right? So this is the table. So based on the table, the view is created, right? So if I modify anything on the table, that modification is affected on the view. But if any affecting on the view, which will not modify on the table, that will not affect on the table. Because view is just an object. If I delete or update anything if I do on the view, that will not affect on the original table. But if I do any changes on the table, that will affect on the view. So if I remove that record from the table, the same record will be deleted from the view also. We don't need to do additionally. But if you remove anything from the view, that effect will not be affected on the table. Okay, so this is a basic relation between the table and views concept. Yes, views and tables. So now we'll discuss one more topic, last topic called as index. So what is an index? So index is basically used for performance, improving the speed. Suppose in real-time environment, there are a lot of tables, thousands of tables will be there, and complex queries will be written. So normally the query will get the data very slow, and to improve the performances, we use index concept. We use index concept to improve the performance of the database. So user perspective, we don't see any much difference, but internally there is a lot of difference from performance perspective. So how to create an index is, indexes we can create in one column or multiple columns. In a table, we can create index on one column or multiple columns. So if you want to create an index, suppose I have an employees table. So let's say I have employees table here. So I have employees table. On this particular table, I have multiple columns. I want to create an index of one column. So on which column we need to prepare the index. So normally whichever column is having more complicated data. So whichever column is having more complicated data. So usually we will create indexes on that particular column. So we'll create indexes on that particular column. So basically how the indexes is working is very simple, guys. Normally whenever you have books, right? The first page will be the index page, right? So I have 100 pages are there in my book. 100 pages are there in my book. If I don't have index, what happens if you want to search for some content, you need to go for every page and somewhere you will find out that information or that content, right? So this is a difficult process. And if you have created one index page at the beginning of the book and so concept is present on so and so page, then we can directly open that particular page and get the data, right? So the same thing will be work on SQL part also. When I create an index on the column and when I try to retrieve the data from the table, it will first check the index and based on the address, it will go to that particular location to the memory and get the records. So it will make a faster execution. So the main usage of index, that is internal mechanism of internal execution process of index. So when I say select star from employees, there are multiple columns I have. So I want to create an index on one particular column. Let's say employee ID column, I want to create an index. So to create an index on employee on particular column, we have to write this statement, create index. Index is also a kind of an object in SQL. So create index, name of the index, some name you have to give. You can give any name. Let's say IDX representing some index and employees table on table name and column name, we have to specify. So create index, index name on table name and specific column. In which table, which column, you have to create an index. And when I execute this command, this will create a new index on this particular column. Now, where these indexes will be stored, when I refresh your HR database, and if you go to the tables and employees and columns, and these are the columns, and here if you go to indexes, so here it will be created a new index. So here, what is my index name is IDX employees. So this is a new index which is created on employees ID column, sorry, employees first name column, employees first name column. And if you want to drop the index, again, same command, drop index, index name. So drop index, index name, and on which table we created this index? On employees table. So that table also we have to specify. So when I execute this, the index will be dropped. Now you refresh here, the index is gone. So these indexes basically used by the performance people. So to performance tuning, all these things in this exactly in their area. So performance team will be using this indexes concept, especially for the database designers. They will use this indexes concept to improve the database performance. So that is all about index. That is all about index. Views as well as index. Okay.